We're spending some time with Dr. Stephen Marsh, who's at the corner of Cedar and Brainerd Road in his offices right now, right off the highway at 271. Doctor, it's our lunch hour. Did you even get a chance to eat yet or no?
Yeah, actually, before we started this, I had a peanut butter and jelly sandwich. I brushed and flossed, maintained my hygiene, and keep my teeth for a lifetime. That's my goal.
You know what? Let's talk about that. Brushing and flossing. Why is that so important?
So what happens, Joe, is after you eat, especially things with sugar in them, like the jelly and the peanut butter and jelly, we always have bacteria in our mouths, and the bacteria feeds off the foods, the carbohydrates, breaks that down into an acid. And for about 30 minutes, that acid attacks the tooth. And that's what causes decay. And that's why we always tell people brush and floss. You want to eliminate that food source for the bacteria. And the sooner you can do it after eating, the better off you're going
to
be.
Yeah, and that decay can lead, of course, to cavities. And then you got to get that decay out of there when you take care of the cavity, correct?
Right, and that's when patients come to us to restore their teeth.
Look, Mom, no cavities. Remember that?
Sure do.
All right, let's start by getting some before and afters here. I love this. With certain patients that you want to feature. Who are we starting with today, Doc?
So we'll start with Ann, and often I show upper teeth and veneers, that sort of thing. We did some veneers on her uppers, but what I want to focus on is she had had a lot of decay over the years. So what we did in the lower front was we used porcelain veneers after we eliminated the decay, and in the back she had had lots of decay, and we put zirconium crowns, which are a type of porcelain, very strong. So we first eliminate the decay, and then we put the restorations on. So she should have a lifetime now of being decay-free as long as she maintains that.
No doubt about it. Okay. And who is next? Who's this?
So this is Mike. So you can see two old crowns that were done years ago. He said he had had a lot of decay. That was porcelain on metal. So we took those off. We eliminated the decay. We put two crowns on the front and then used porcelain veneers to complete his smile. Mm. What happens with crowns and fillings is after a period of time, if they leak around the margin, just like windows may leak around the outside, they have to be replaced. So today we're able to do that in a pretty beautiful way and conservative as well.
Smashing smile. Love it. Beautiful. And, now this is a perfect example of someone changing their smile and really changing their entire look.
Yeah. So Sharon was in her 40s and she admitted that she drank a lot of pop. And you talk about a food source that causes decay. Sugared pop are really a problem, especially because it takes a little longer to drink them. And so you're exposing your teeth for a lot longer time. So with Sharon, we're doing it in stages. We did six teeth in the front, reshaped them, took out the decay, restored those with a couple of crowns and veneers to give her a beautiful smile and one that's now decay-free. But we've encouraged her to switch to a no-sugar pop if she wants
Good advice. Great advice. See, I love the fact we learned so much during these times. All right, who's next?
And this is Martin. Martin was unhappy with his smile. Now, his front tooth turned dark. He said he was an athlete. He fell, injured that tooth. He had tried whitening. It really doesn't respond well to whitening, and he wanted a nice smile. And we ended up doing six veneers and reshaping the bottom to give him a beautiful smile. And once again, there was some decay. We eliminated that first before we placed the veneer.
And we have time for one more patient. And who is it?
So this is Michelle. And Michelle's teeth had spaced out, if you will, after a while. Her bite was off. We reshaped the lowers. She had posterior, meaning in the back she had decay. We eliminated that first. Then she said, let's do something for my smile. I'm seeing lots of people with spaces that now want to close them out. Her teeth had moved forward over time. We brought those back just by reshaping them and did six porcelain veneers to give her a smile that she's proud of. And she meets with lots of people, does a lot of speaking. So she said, I really feel confident for the first time in a long time.
Well, if you want to keep your smile healthy and have a smile that you're proud of, let Dr. Marsh and his team help you out with that. Simply call 440-461-1003, or you can log on to the website, clevelandsmiles.com. Doctor, as always, great spending time with you.
Thanks, and now I'm going to go back to work.
I'm going to go have a peanut butter and jelly sandwich.
Just brush and floss afterwards.
Promise.